So how come you never want to come to the movies with me?
Come on, Mommy. I want to sit up front.
So what's this movie about? Missionaries or something?
No, you'll like it. It's a Hollywood movie.
Dear lady, I knew you'd come back to us. I knew it.
You are unhappy, my daughter.
Only because of my mother, but not anymore. You're here. Tell us what you'd have us do.
Jesus wishes to use you to make me known and loved. He wishes to establish throughout the world devotion to me. So you must learn to read and write in order that you may convey his message.
Do you hear a lady's voice?
I hear a buzz.
During one of her visits, the children received several predictions from Our Lady. She predicted a Second World War, the insidious growth of international communism. And after much suffering and the martyrdom of many Christians, the eventual conversion of Russia. At the end, she told them one last prediction, more important than any of the others, and she swore them to secrecy. Lucia wrote the secret in a letter which was sealed with instructions from Our Lady that it be opened on October 13th, 1960, on the anniversary of her last appearance at Fatima.
Wow, that's next week.
How about that?
Dear God, please make the news from Our Lady's letter be good. And I will sit here for 5 minutes without moving. I promise. Okay, thank you.
You check on the Daily Doubles at Belmont?
Daddy.
That's last night's.
Oh.
What are you looking for?
News about the letter.
What letter?
The letter with the secret from Our Lady of Fatima. The Pope was supposed to open it yesterday.
Did you check Dear Abby? Sweetheart, I bet the Pope won't tell. He'll keep it a secret for about 6 months or so. And then when everybody forgets about it, he'll announce it like he thought it up himself. That's what he does. You know?
Honey, go get your books. We're going to be late as it is.
I can't believe this.
When was the conversion of Constantine?
324 years after the birth of our blessed Lord Jesus.
Very good. Now, take down the following dates. These will all be included on your test Friday. 325 B.C. Constantine convened the first ecumenical council. Someone had better tell me what's going on in this classroom. There are a lot of very jittery people here who are making it difficult for those of us who are trying to learn.
Excuse me, sister, but this whole thing is about us being confused about the letter of Fatima. You see, the Pope should have opened it 3 days ago, and he didn't say nothing about it.
Well, if that's what the Pope's decided, he knows best.
No letter, sweetheart?
No.
You know, when I was little, the nuns told me a beautiful story about the Virgin and the angel Gabriel. You know the Annunciation, right? When Gabriel visits Mary and he tells her that she's going to give birth to the Son of God? Well, right after he did this, he's just about ready to fly off. When Mary grabs him by the tip of his wing and holds him back like this. And she says, "Excuse me, but this thing that is happening to me, is it a miracle?" "Oh, yes," says Gabriel. And he's just about ready to fly off again. And again, she grabs him and holds him back. "And this baby that I'm going to give birth to, will that be a miracle too?" "Oh, yes," he said. "That's always a miracle. But this birth will be the greatest one of all." And he goes to her, "You know, Madonna, miracles are all around us, but life is too short to sit around and wait for them. We are the ones who must seek them out."
I don't get it.
Honey, the point is, who knows? Maybe the story of the letter was made up by the guy who sells souvenirs at Fatima. Or maybe the Virgin is trying to teach us what Gabriel taught her. That life is too short to sit around and wait for a miracle.
Dear Jesus, why are you punishing us like this? Why can't we know the secret? Why? Are you mad at somebody? At me? I know I did something wrong. What was it? Please tell me. Show me how to change. Okay.